My name is Anil Mathur, and I have the pleasure, or I would say honor, of serving as the director of our behavioral research lab here at Hofstra. And I am also serving as the chair of marketing, international business, and legal studies department. Different elements of consumer behavior fascinate me, and I got involved in this area to a deeper extent. And then at Hofstra, we got an opportunity to build this lab. Fortunately, Noldus came along, and they were a great partner in helping us design and set up this human behavior research lab. The objective of this lab was threefold. It was not just my research, but we started out this lab with three main ideas. We wanted this lab to be a resource for our students, a resource for our faculty, and a resource for our community. So we built it in a way that students get to learn cutting-edge technology. I am always looking at different phenomena and being curious why it is happening, how it is happening, especially human behavior. I am a consumer behavior person, but broadly human behavior. And people do many things. And I am always curious to understand why they are doing this and what is the consequence, what is making them do things. One of the most important thing that I'm working on and trying to find ways of doing it is we are now able to collect data using multiple technologies. Could be eye tracking, could be facial analysis, could be even voice analysis. How do we combine data coming in from eye tracking, data coming in from facial analysis, data coming in from voice analysis, although they all represent the same underlying emotions? We designed it to be able to do research in many different areas. We wanted it to be a resource for all faculty, and naturally different colleagues have different interests and so on. So we deliberately attempted to build a lab with great deal of flexibility that we should be able to use multiple tools, and those tools should be available in multiple contexts. So the design which Noldus helped was to make it more flexible, add more tools than we needed at that time. And now we are finding that it is of great value. Whether it is controlling video feeds from a control room, whether we are looking at combining video and audio analysis or eye tracking analysis together, the degree of flexibility is the one that is important to us, or it was important to us to be able to do different types of research. One of the things that these resources, especially those through Noldus we have been able to acquire, help us understand human emotions. And we know that emotions drive a lot of behavior, but then emotions are hidden most of the time. People try to hide their expressions, you know, try to be neutral. But then fortunately, face reader is sophisticated enough to look at even micro emotions and find out what may be driving their thoughts and their behavior based on that. We have also been using Viso. In our lab, we have cameras installed in all lab rooms, conference room, individual meeting rooms, and those video cameras feed into our control room. And Viso is a very valuable tool that we find in recording video feeds from all these cameras. The advice I would give is, think of the future. We have access to things what we have today, but once we build the lab, we should be able to look for answers to questions that will come up tomorrow. In other words, the lab should be such that it is forward-looking, it is future-looking, so that we can incorporate even new tools that come along and are able to integrate with what we are able to do today. Actually, that was one of the driving things when we asked Noldus to help us design this lab, that I don't want to design the lab with my today's research questions. I want to design the lab that can help me research questions 5 years down the road. And fortunately, actually, this is exactly what is happening. New problems, new questions will come up that I would like to answer tomorrow.